in the WPI instance, we have a little more detail. The number for March end has come in at 5.3, actually 5.29. In the old series, it was 5.7. So there's a 40 basis point lower WPI inflation according to the new series. Any thoughts at all, if you could read up or hear what the CSO was saying?
I couldn't get the entire text of what CSO was saying, but I think clearly if we abstract away from the current numbers, what the CSO is trying to do is to make it more contemporary. So I would have more faith in the new series than I would have in the previous one, because 2004-05 was the year when the economy actually started picking up. And I think there's been a lot of change, structural change in the economy since then. I think all that wasn't getting reflected in the previous series. But I think now low CPI, low WPI, I think the issue it's been a big surprise, I would say. I think both CPI and WPI also. But the critical question is that, is the sustainability of this? I mean, are we in a trajectory that we can confidently say that we'll get 4% inflation on a sustainable basis? My answer to that would be no. I think we haven't done enough for that. As far as our current projections are concerned, I think we expect CPI to average at 5%. I think I would say that there is some downward bias to that. Mm. One should also remember that globally, I think the economies are reflating. So there is an upward price pressure, which also transmits back to us. I think fortunately, the rupee has strengthened, so that is muting that impact to some extent.
So your year-end is 5%, Dr. Joshi?
This is definitely a pleasant surprise, both in CPI and WPI.
Okay. Your year-end number?
Our average is 5%. We don't project the year-end number. We do the average for the...
Okay.
Yeah, year-end number would be approximately around that.
5%?
A little lower than 5%.
No, considering that we will have several months of sub 3%.
Yeah. So there are... Yeah, but I think there are pressure points which could emerge. I think it's hard to predict. Inflation has been notoriously mischievous, I mean, I would say. I think it's always surprised the analyst and the policy makers, I think. And I think right now we are in a downward surprise. And I think as was being pointed out, as the pay commission and other factors come into play, and if oil prices were to strengthen a little more, I think we would, and rupee were to weaken from here, which we expect it would, I think we would see some upward pressure on both CPI and WPI inflation. And I think, as I said, from a central bank perspective, if 4% is the target that they are going, I think we haven't done enough to ensure 4% on a sustainable basis over the next couple of years. I think that would require a lot of effort from the government in correcting the food balance in the system, and I think we are some time away from there. That would be my concern. But clearly, for this year, there is a I would agree that there is a downward bias to the estimate that we have, which is 5%, because of these developments, because of the pleasant surprise.
Okay.
And monsoons, I think, I would say that monsoons, more than monsoons, is the government policy that is critical for inflation. Mm. If you see the last two years, the monsoon was unfavorable, yet the food inflation did come down. Mm. And I think a lot of global factors and domestic factors were responsible for that. So I think what government does is more critical for food inflation than monsoons do matter. But I think what government does is also critical.
Yeah, I just wanted to read out some of the numbers. As Shaumya pointed out, it's almost a crash in the prices of pulses. Mm. It is a contraction in pulses prices by about 16% year on year, and even month on month there has been a steadying of pulses prices. It's not rising. Among the others, cereals is 5%, meat and fish 1.9%, egg 3.5%, milk 4.7%, oils and fats 3.1%, fruit 3.7%, vegetables, again it's a contraction, -8.5%. Pulses, I already read 16% over, 15.94 to be precise, and sugar is up 11%. very quickly, food and beverages, therefore, is up just 1.2%.
Wow.
That's about very low food inflation that we have seen, at least for the month of April. We have seen it perhaps in the months of December, Jan, but 1.2% would be some kind of a historic low, I would think, in food prices. Clothing is 4.5%, housing is 4.8%, fuel and light 6.1%, and miscellaneous, largely services, is 4.2%. As Soumya was pointing out, services or core mm-hmm. inflation is as low as 4.3%. So this looks like a seminal fall in prices. Soumya, will this do anything to bond prices tomorrow, or they are going to go regardless because of the Reserve Bank's hawkish stance?
I think that the general mood in the market should be buoyant because a sub 3% number coming so early as in April. Mm. I mean, the market was not expecting that. And if this trend continues, and the way the prices have been moving in this month also, if you look into the data, this month also the price decline is continuing. So possibly a favorable number next couple of months, and the bond market possibly could take solace of that, because the new 10-year bond today has been rallying. So mm-hmm. it was issued at 6.79%, and it has already rallied by around 6 basis points to at what are 6.73. So there is some comfort in the market regarding the inflation data which has been released,
mm-hmm.
or anticipation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Indraneel, I wanted to come to you about the same point. Food inflation, what is the trajectory that you're projecting at least in the next 2 to 3 odd months?
The very sharp crash in the pulses prices may not be repeated month on month basis, because we have seen a bumper output in terms of the pulses given the rise in the MSP that we had seen on the pulses the previous year. Therefore, definitely we can't expect the MSP rises leading to output gains year on year, and anyways we are to a certain extent deficient in terms of the overall supply that we can generate domestically vis-a-vis the demand that we have domestically for pulses. So the point being made is that we are possibly again to a certain extent near the floor in terms of how inflation and the trajectory of the inflation needs to move. Now, given the fact that the core is still quite sticky, I think that is also on the radar of the Reserve Bank of India, though the overall targeting is done on the headline CPI. And the moment these sort of effects in terms of the food prices coming lower reverses, we can definitely be higher than the 4% is what needs to be believed in.
Okay. Well, actually, I'm trying to get the new industrial output numbers, but we only have some text on the revision.
Mm.
We don't have the new IIP numbers except what we have got from the wires. So my sense is that it's been given by way of a press release. The new IIP number for April, new series, is 2.7% electricity versus 1.9% in the previous month. Mm. Electricity has come in at 6.2% compared to 1.2% in the previous month. Manufacturing has come at 9.7%. There must be some mistake over here, because if manufacturing is 9.7, how will the overall industrial output be 2.7? I would assume that
9.7.
Yeah, it looks.
Then maybe everything else had to have declined for if only
mining output is 9.7. Okay, manufacturing is 1.2.
Hmm.
That explains. Manufacturing is 1.2, and the overall March industrial output is 2.7%. Any thoughts on this? This is the new series, Soumya. I'll just read it out to you. March industrial output is 2.7 compared to 1.9 in February. March manufacturing is 1.2 compared to 1.4 in the previous month, that is February. And mining is 9.7 compared to 4.6. These are March and February numbers. Any thoughts in terms of industrial output?
See, at a first glance, if I recollect it, I think the total number of items under the manufacturing group was around 620 in 2004-05,
yes.
Which has now been increased to 809.
Mm.
So close to I think 190 odd commodities has been attended, and I possibly think that the weighting structure could have been a little bit revised. For example, the share of manufacturing may have declined a little bit, because that's the trend which we have witnessed over the years in, if you look into the previous IIP series also. So my sense is that if the volatile items which were there over there in the IIP series in terms of the rubber insulated cables, which used to have a large upward bias on the numbers, so I would like to see how those numbers has now been treated, because there is a very, there is a one page press release on the website which doesn't say anything. It only talks about the number of items and not even in terms of the weightages. So once you get the weightages, which obviously could be on the a little bit go down, and then you can understand and see whether the series will be volatile as before. Because one statement says that the number, these, as per the new IIP series, the growth rate is higher than the old IIP series on most of the months in the last couple of years.
Yes.
So that gives you an idea that possibly some of the volatile items may have been weeded out from this current IIP index.
Okay. No, I take your point. Do you have any of the details at all in front of you, Indranil, or you are not with a computer at the moment?
Sorry, I'm not with the computer at the moment.
Okay. Well, there is a detailed press release on weightings as well, Soumyo, on the PIB website. But, it's way too detailed to be able to tell you anything in terms of, on television. But overall, it appears to be that the WPI numbers are marginally lower, at least in 2017, in the new series compared to the old series. And the IIP number, well, we only have the April and February number. The February number has come in at 1.9. What was your previous number, Ekta, would you remember? The previous IIP number?
For 1.9 February compares to a decline, I think, if I'm not mistaken. A marginal decline, I'll just pull it up.
Okay, but anyway, I think your previous number was minus 1.2, you're right. You were expecting a poll of 1.7, your poll gave up 1.7, and the number we have is
2.7.
Okay, so the March IIP has come in at 2.7 compared to a previous February of 1.9, but that 1.9 is the new series.
Yeah.
In the old series, the 1.9 corresponding number is minus 1.2. Any thoughts, Mr. Joshi? It does look like the IIP in the new series makes us look a little better.
Yeah, that would, because I think what was happening was the previous series had elements which were losing relevance and probably were not growing that fast. And the fast growing elements, which I think particularly in the electronic and other segments, which hopefully got included, I think they are the ones which will be captured better. I think so. My sense was that the previous series was underestimating growth because it wasn't capturing the sunrise industries, and some of that has got captured now. But even then, I think at 2.7%, the industrial industry is still not out of the woods. I mean, it's an underperformance, I would say, given particularly that the last year's base was so weak. Mm-hmm. So I think. That's what I would say, but I just want to point out one more thing. I think the Soumitra Chaudhary committee had recommended that the IIP categories and the WPI categories should be synced together.
Okay.
I think that would make it easier to compute the deflator, etc. And also that the excise should be taken out of WPI. I don't know if all that has happened, because if that has happened, that has a lot of relevance for the GDP deflator, which has been in question because of not accurately capturing the price movements. So I think those are two things which I don't know if the press release addresses that.
Okay. Yeah. Soumyo, how should we approach the GDP number now? It looks like the WPI number looks a little lower, and the IIP numbers have come in slightly higher in the new series. I can just give you the last. The old series was minus 1.2 February, now it is 1.9. And likewise, if you take the year ago February, the March is getting cut off over here. If you take the February 2016, the previous was 1.9, the new series is 7.4. That's a big jump. But when you come to 2011-12, it doesn't look like that. The 2011-12 number is 3.2, whereas the old series was 4.8. But for the okay, this is for 15-16. Sorry, for 15-16, we actually have an industrial output in February of about 7.4. So it looks like the new industrial output number is substantially higher than the previous series. Therefore, are you expecting big changes, Soumyo, to the GDP numbers?
No, so no, I don't expect changes to the big GDP number, because I think what will happen is now this IIP number not in consonance with the GDP number. A part of the debate could actually fade away, because if the new IIP number is substantially higher than the old IIP number and has been reported in the press release, I think then the definitional gap between the IIP and the GDP series could possibly decline a little bit. So that will be good for the policymakers. The second thing which I would like to point out is that regarding the WPI data, if you look into the new series, that is 3.85%, and the linking factor is around 1.56. I'm looking at the press release. So the old, so the new data is actually lower than the old WPI data if we compare by using the linking factor.
Sorry, the
and
new
that is
sorry,
precisely
sorry.
Because of the fact that the weightage of primary articles, which was new WPI, if I take the, if we had calculated the old WPI for this month, this could have been lower than the new WPI.
Yes.
This could have been higher than the new WPI. And this is primarily because of the fact that the weightage of primary articles have in fact increased from 20.1 to 22.62% in the new basket. So therefore, now there will be a more amount of convergence in the WPI CPI series, because that was not expected earlier, because the weighted of primary articles was in fact declined in the last time when it was revised. So if that is the case, and if the WPI CPI gap actually narrows, because food article prices are now declining, so therefore you will see that this WPI has also declined this month and CPI has also declined to a new low. So that's a good thing for the policymakers, at least in terms of the WPI CPI wage.
Okay, though I'm really more interested in the fact that the WPI numbers, IIP numbers, are much higher for 12, 13, 13, 14, 14, 15, 15, 16 and 16, 17 compared to what we got in the old series. So Indranil, won't the GDP get revised higher for prior years as well?
I doubt because anyways in terms of the calculation of the manufacturing segment, we were taking the new format for the GVA calculation, which was more realistic than the than what was getting reflected out of the IIP. Out of the IIP, it was more the representation of the informal sort of sector, which was a very small portion in overall calculation of the manufacturing GVA. The critical element also is that manufacturing as an overall GVA is relatively smaller. It's the services sector which was in terms of the share was a higher side. And for the last year and probably also for this year, another key determinant would be the agricultural output in terms of determining what your pace of momentum in terms of GVA stroke the GDP would be. So I really don't believe that the IIP new series will have a very dramatic implication in terms of the calculation of the GDP numbers.
Okay. No, I'll tell you why there is still just a niggling doubt. It's possible that the old series will anyway look at the ASI data, and therefore the revised numbers will not change. These are after all quick estimates. But in the quick estimates, definitely our statisticians made us look worse than we probably actually were, because the new data indicates that the IIP number was not all that bad. For instance, for all of FY17, under the new series, we have grown by 5%. In the old series, we would have grown by 0.7%. That's a big difference. 4.5 percentage points, we have grown faster in IIP in the new series compared to the old series. Likewise, last year, FY16, if we had the new series, we would have grown by 3.4. In the old series, we grew by 2.4. FY16, we would have grown by 4%. In the old series, we grew by only 2.8%. So at least for, why even in the year before, 13-14, we would have grown by 3.4% in the new series. We did only minus 0.1 in the old series. Actually, if the old series was there, maybe the UPA government would not have lost so badly, because the numbers are making us look a little better than what these numbers, the old numbers indicated. Now, at least for 15, 16 and 16, 17, will not that May 31st GDP feed in the new IIP numbers, Soumyo? So, both last year's and this year's GDP could get revised higher, you think?
No, I would tend to agree. As of now, there may not be any significant revision in the data, because the point which I just mentioned, because I think the earlier what was happening was the GDP was increasing, but there was a severe disconnect with the IIP numbers. Now that the IIP numbers are revised a little bit, I don't see any reason why this IIP, and I think they were following the same methodology in terms of the construction of this index.
So, no, they used to take the IIP.
One part of the note, it is clearly stated that it doesn't take it.
No, Inder, they used to take the quarterly IIP number to calculate the GDP. Only after 2 years, they went to ASI. But last quarter's GDP, the one that came on February 28th or the one that came on November 30th, what would be the quarterly addition from industry? It would be the IIP.
No, it would be the IIP, but the other factor which you'd look into, in the note itself, I have not gone through the note in details, but if you look into one part of the note itself, it clearly says that it doesn't take into account the unorganized segment and so on, only the organized segment. So my sense is that even though the IIP factor is a factor in the estimation of the GDP number, I don't see too much of a material impact on the GDP number, which will be released on 31st May.
Oh, right.
Because hopefully the CSO could have already taken that factor into account while he was calculating the GDP.
Oh, that we will really have to ask Professor Anand, whether the new series already incorporates the changes incorporated into the current IIP number. If not, we could be in for a pleasant surprise. WPI is lower and IIP is higher, therefore the real GVA should logically be a little higher than what we were given to understand. Now, this is a question which only Professor Anand can answer. Well, since I have to leave all of you to read the new release and the new weights, I'll let you do that. Thank you very much for giving us some perspective, despite the fact that you really don't have a very good idea of the details of the new revisions. Soumyo, Dr. Joshi and Indra Nilpan, thank you very much for joining us in this discussion. Well, short point is good news. First of all, for the first time in the new series, we have a CPI number for April, which is below 3%. And experts are telling us that we are going to remain below 3% for the next 3 months. Good news for the consumer and good news for the bond markets. The second important number is the IIP number for FY17 is a very decent 5%. We have not had a decent 5% number for the last 6-7 years in the old IIP series, thanks to just this statistical base changing. Lo and behold, our industrial growth is not so bad. It is 5%, and last year also 3.4%. The third was the WPI number. There again, the wholesale price inflation is not as bad as it was in the old series. So the new base year brings us good tidings. That's it on this special coverage of the macroeconomic numbers. Thanks for watching. More news and updates follow.